Hey, hey, it's David of Strong by Lee. Today I want to spend the next couple of minutes talking to you about pessimism. Pessimism, what good will come out of talking about negativity? Turns out there are a lot of good things that can come out of talking about negativity. It's not just about negativity, and that's one of the things I want to clear up. Pessimism is not just about negativity. But hold up, Dave. Isn't your job as a personal trainer, registered dietitian, to help your clients look, move, and feel better? Isn't one of your responsibilities to lift them up, motivate them, be positive? Yes. And no, I think it's very context dependent. It's conditional. I am reading this extremely interesting book titled Pessimism by a political science professor at Princeton, Joshua Dienstag. And he goes into the history of pessimism. One of the first things he gets out of the way is that pessimism is a state of mind. It's a mentality. Whereas there is a such thing called philosophical pessimism. Philosophical pessimism being different than just being negative. And while the notion of pessimism is built on the foundation of philosophical pessimism, there are a lot of detailed nuances that many people miss and overlook mistakenly about philosophical pessimism that I think can be useful and valuable. I think one of my main responsibilities as a personal trainer is to help align my clients' goals with their expectations. Many people come to me with unrealistic goals and expectations, even though they think their goals and expectations are realistic. So when they eventually don't reach their goals, or they're not making the progress at the rate they had hoped, despite their best intentions, and even when they know their efforts are being derailed on a regular basis from factors outside and inside of their controls, yes, people self-sabotage all the time, they still get upset. They get emotionally wound up and involved. They get angry. They get disappointed. They feel like a failure. And when these emotions accumulate too much, the likelihood of them quitting is very high. And we don't want somebody to quit, because health and fitness are very important. You're delaying the inevitable with health and fitness, the inevitable being death. Death might sound pessimistic, but pessimism has been around for a very long time. The actual word has only been around since the 17th century, but the mentality has been around for several millennium. For example, the ancient Greeks, the ancient Romans, the Buddhists practiced pessimistic exercises. They did negative visualization. They thought life was suffering and grievances. For example, one of the core tenets of Buddhism is life is suffering. If you were to go up to a random personality and say, hey bro, life is suffering. Oh, thanks for the uplifting message in a sarcastic tone. That's because life is suffering is a pessimistic message. But the Buddhists knew life is suffering. Look all around you. We are so much more sensitive and susceptible to negativity, because if we weren't, we probably wouldn't have survived this long. Studies suggest we are at least 7 to 9 times more sensitive to negative situations, stressful situations, but that ensures a higher probability of us surviving, because stressful situations usually killed us. Grateful journaling does not save our lives. Being alert to dangerous activities does, and that's negativity. If you were to wake up tomorrow and say to yourself, there's a real possibility I could die today. There's a possibility I can get shot, stabbed, robbed, kidnapped. There's a real possibility that this can happen. What are the chances? Probably low, depending on where you live. But there is a real possibility, because it happens every single day. It's probably more realistic to wake up and say, today, I'm probably going to run into somebody who is an asshole, who's disrespectful, who has other things going on in their lives they're suffering from, so they're going to not be very nice, they're going to be selfish, they're going to be greedy, they're probably going to push me out of the way, they're not going to hold the door for me. And that's pessimistic, and that is an exercise that the ancient Stoics used called premeditatio malorum, the premeditation of evil. And this is a naturally pessimistic exercise in which they are mentally preparing themselves for negative situations. And it's not because they're negative people, but it's because they're trying to lower their expectations. They understand life can throw them many negative curveballs. And if you're not ready to catch those curveballs, you are going to get knocked flat on your ass a lot harder. You're going to hurt. It's going to hurt a lot more. You're going to fall from further. However, if you bolster yourself, if you prepare yourself, armor yourself for those negative things, you might not get affected as much. It's kind of like saying, you know, I studied for this exam. I didn't study as well as I could. I'm expecting a C, but you actually get a B. You're pleasantly surprised. If you get a C, you're not surprised because that's kind of what you guessed. If you get a D, it's probably not going to make as much of an impact because you guessed you were going to get a C. That's premeditatio malorum. That is one of the main pessimistic exercises. It's a stoic exercise. It's not naturally a pessimistic exercise, or it's not a pessimistic exercise the way that we conventionally view pessimism. And I think it's very beneficial because in an age where optimism, sometimes toxic optimism, is forced onto people, you got to be grateful. You have to look at the bright side of things. You have to get over it. Things are going to get better before they get worse. In actuality, things will probably get worse before they get better, you know? And that's just been my experience. I mean, I'm only 33 years old, but I work with enough people who are a little bit more advanced in age, and they experience these things. You know, nobody is immune or invincible to tragic events. When it comes to health and fitness, and you experience a tragic loss in your family, you lose your friend, or something happens to you that can alter the course of your life, those are tragic. And those have a real effect, a deleterious effect on your health and fitness efforts. And you have to be prepared for that. So this isn't a segment about just pessimism. It's about trying to manage your expectations of reality. Life is suffering. Life is difficult. And I think if we can try to make our health and fitness a little bit more philosophical than just it being about losing weight, lifting weights, eating the right foods, and sleeping, then I think we're going to find a lot more meaning and purpose behind our health efforts. Let me know what you think. If you have any questions, or even if you don't, please let me know. Shoot them over to me at david@strongbylee.com. I'm going to love talking about pessimism, so expect me to talk about pessimism a lot more in future segments.